Chris from the band Lexington, here to talk to you about bootlegger guitars, specifically today, the Rye, because I've got it with me. The Rye has an ashwood body, Brazilian rosewood neck, 3x3 up here at the top. And there's a lot of great videos on the Bootlegger Guitar Channel with guys showing you what these things can sound like. My interpretation of that is that as a viewer, when I go and I watch those things, I think about a couple of things. One of those things being, I've got like three dozen guitars, basically, just because I have a sickness. And I noticed that whether the guitar is a $200 guitar or a $2,000 guitar, a lot of times I sound the same no matter what I'm playing on. So what defines whether or not I choose a guitar or want to play a guitar is how well that guitar feels, and if it can be adjusted to the way I like to play it. So a little bit about this model in particular. It weighs about 9 pounds, which if you enjoy playing a Les Paul or having that extra kind of weight hang there, I like that. That's a big seller for me. If it's feels heavy or heavier, it tends to resonate better for me. It just feels good. It feels more secure sitting on my shoulder, and I think the way I play is somewhat influenced by having that weight. If I have too light of a guitar, I don't know, I play it kind of differently or strange or whatever. Also for me, the ability to make it the way I want it to feel. So right out of the box, again, whether it's a $200 guitar, a $2,000 guitar or more, I'm still going to set my guitars up the way that it feels good for me to play. So that's everything from making sometimes an adjustment to the nut, being able to adjust the truss rod, and this obviously has a cover here where you can do that. And once I get the neck where I want it, and then I'm able to, it's hard to see on this because it's black, but adjust the saddles and everything in this spot. The way this guitar is set up to make those adjustments, very similar to maybe an Epiphone Les Paul as opposed to a Gibson Les Paul. And same equipment here, but why I say there's a difference, some of my Epiphone guitars have the adjustment screws facing the neck, and that's a lot easier to work on the intonation for me than it is on a Gibson, where you're coming at them between the stop bar and here, where it's difficult to get in there with a screwdriver. So point for this versus my Les Pauls, actually. You can see that it's set up much like a Les Paul, and then it's got the two-way switch, three-way switch, actually, for the pickups. Pickups are double coil here. They're humbuckers. And I've played this guitar direct through PA systems and through the amp. They're very quiet, which is nice. Single volume, single tone, and they both work in that they actually do something. So there's a lot of variation between both the volume and tone knobs. The tone knob, I typically will just run it full on in the treble position. I think most of us probably do that. But if you do want to dial down back and forth a little bit, it's definitely noticeable where I've had guitars where, maybe it does a little something, maybe it just makes it dirty and muddy and that's all. This actually has some tonal variations, which works well. You get kind of black chrome knobs, which, you know, you were probably gonna pull your knobs off, your plastic knobs off of something, and you were gonna put these on them anyway, so this already comes with it. It's a nice thing. The tuners are a little bit more like a Grover style tuner. And they feel that they're tight in the sense that they are, when you make the adjustment's firm and it's nice and it holds in tune, which is a good thing. I like that. And they're very smooth when you're winding the strings up. I believe things do come standard with 10s. 10s are what I use, D'Addario 10s, but I don't know if these are D'Addario or not D'Addario, but they're 10s and they were great. If a guitar doesn't feel good, specifically the neck, I don't want to play it. You probably don't want to play it either. Sharp frets don't make for fun, enjoyable playing. This neck has a C or like a slight D profile. To me, it feels more like an easy D, which is a lot more like a Les Paul. If you're used to that, I love it. It's very comfortable. I didn't have to do anything to this. I didn't have to shave any burrs off the edge. There were no sharp pieces there at all. It was really great. So why is all this important? You know, when you are either a beginning guitar player or you've been playing for a long time, you don't want to hassle with a lot of details. Or if you have been playing for a long time and you know exactly what you want and how you want to be able to set it up, you want something that's going to allow you to do that. So this does allow that to happen in a pretty simple, easy way. I set this thing up the way I like them, and I'm a little slow at it, but it you know, about an hour. Also, you get all of this shipped directly to you for like $550, and that comes with a hard case. So, you know, a lot of times you'll find a really good deal on a guitar, what feels like a good deal, and then you're getting a gig bag with it. And you're probably gonna, if you're like me, you're gonna look around maybe Craigslist or your local guitar shop on a sale, and you're gonna find a hard case that you're gonna end up putting it in anyway, and you're gonna spend extra money. This comes with a hard case for like $550. Really great guitar. You can go look at all the other videos on some of the Bootlegger products, stuff on YouTube, and you're gonna find guys that are amazing players. They're just shredding, and it's great. I love that stuff too. But just to really specifically talk about the guitar itself and why, especially at that price point, this is a great deal. You can buy these things all day long and you're gonna be happy with them. If you guys are around and you're able to be in Anaheim at the end of next week and you're gonna be at the NAMM show, you can come up, check out Bootlegger Guitar. I think all of the models are going to be there. I think it's like six or seven. I've personally played four of them and they're great. They're really good guitars. Come by, check them out, meet the owner, and you know, I'll be there. I'll be there the whole time, but I'll be there plenty of time. Love to talk to you about them. I really do enjoy them, really do like them, really do believe in the company, the guitars and the amps. So hopefully we'll see you there. Thanks again, and see you again soon.
Hey everyone, Sean Pierce Johnson here on behalf of Bootlegger Guitar, and this is the Rye, a very classy looking guitar that sounds as mean as it looks. Let's take a listen. Of an ash body, a set maple neck, and of course the trademark Bootlegger headstock. This is an absolute banger of a guitar. The body and the fretboard are bound, the beautiful rosewood fretboard with the whiskey diamond inlays, I might add. Very, very cool look. Covered black humbuckers, black tunematic and stop tail piece bridge, master volume, master tone, and a three-way toggle switch. It's a very simple guitar that produces a lot of great tones, and we're gonna hear a few of them right now. Let's hear a few clean sounds, let's hear some dirty sounds, and maybe even a little bit of fuzz. that, my friends, is a little preview of the Rye from Bootlegger Guitar, a hot rod rock machine if there ever was one. I'm going to go ahead and have a little bit more fun with this, but if you'd like to see a more in-depth demo and review of this particular Bootlegger guitar, please check out my YouTube channel at youtube.com/SeanPierceJohnson, and you'll be able to see that full demo in all of its glory. Until next time, my friends, I'm Sean Pierce Johnson, wishing you all out there great tone and happy stomping. Cheers.
And hello, it's Chris, the band Lexington, for another Bootlegger video. And so it's kind of quiet here. So I'm sitting here tonight, got my Bootlegger Rye, which I'm loving, and just kind of noodling a little bit. I love how you kind of dig into it.